approach to study language as a cognitive and mental phenomenon. It is a theoretical paradigm that sees language as embedded in cognition and therefore motivated by cognitive processes. So, one of the basic tenets of cognitive linguistics is that it's a belief that language is not arbitrary. In other words, it is motivated. So, cognitive processes such as analogy, associations, mental imagery, and metaphors can all motivate languages. So, linguistic motivation can come as three different types. First, we have meaning motivation. Why do we say things are looking up? He fell into depression because there are the metaphors good and happy are up, and bad and sad are down. Okay. So the second type is a form meaning motivation. We all know the onomatopoeia. And another example are phonetic themes. Think about these words, spit, spill, spy, spat. So we can feel the negative complications denoted by the forms in these words. Okay, it can also come as a form for motivation. We say time will tell. It takes two to tango. We never say time will stay. It takes two to waltz. Why? Because there is a phonological motivation underlying these expressions. So, the notion of linguistic motivation can open up new perspectives for language teachers in explaining language structures and providing meta-linguistic knowledge to L2 learners. So here we have some empirical studies which show that asking learners to reflect on the linguistic motivation can boost vocabulary learning. Just for your information, my research mainly focused on the adult learners in formal classroom teaching settings. So, cognitive engagement by means of linguistic motivation may carry the potential to enhance foreign language teaching. First, revealing the linguistic motivation underlying the form and meanings can help learners to better comprehend and remember the target items, because these can create additional memory trees. Second, the revelation of the metaphors and metonymies embedded in the second language can enhance learners' cultural awareness. So last, it may raise learners' recognition of language as motivated rather than arbitrary. So in a nutshell, explicit attention to the linguistic motivation might lead to more insightful foreign language learning instead of rote learning. This is the reference. So moving on to our second element, the Chinese character learning. Most of you may have the feeling that Chinese character is a tough nut to crack. Yes, there is another challenge, is the tone. But remember that the tone is also part of the character. So Chinese characters can cause great cognitive load for second language learners, especially for those with alphabetic language backgrounds. In contrast to words in alphabetic actually have a special built up which can carry the potential of a cognitive linguistics-inspired approach. This led us to explore such kind of teaching methods. So before I move on to our current study on the textbooks, I would like to introduce a bit about the underlying for 13.4. So these are the examples of each kind of linguistic motive, which I will not go to the details in. So these are the percent of each type of linguistic motivation. We can see that meaning motivation is the most frequent type of linguistic motivation found in our corpus. So these are our main preliminary findings. So only a small proportion of Chinese character exercises rely on linguistic motivation, and meaning connection stands out as the most frequent type of linguistic motivation. And shape focused exercises without linguistic motivation play a predominant part in our data. So no exercises encouraging learner generated motivation on characters were found. So in next we are going to conduct an investigation of perceived effectiveness of Chinese character exercises from the perspective of teachers and students, and we are going to conduct an empirical intervention study that will compare the cognitive linguistics informed character instruction with a traditional teaching method. So I would like to close my presentation with a very interesting exercise sheet designed by one of my friends who is a Chinese language teacher in Finland. And this is for university students actually. And it's a very small